just a simple idea. We wanted people to do something that would, like, change a community. So we decided that we could go for something basic as growing something.
I didn't know at the start that onions and garlics could survive through the winter. So that's why we're giving out 2 onions and a garlic in a pot.
We gave them away to people who play for veg.
Cameron.
Amy.
Lauren.
Jenna.
Pledge for Veg is us asking for your support in growing veg and fruits in your own garden and to reduce food miles.
Lucinda.
Courtney.
Beth.
James.
We've decided to get 10,000 pledges.
It's a promise to say that you'll try to grow at least one piece of veg this year.
There's not many people in our locality that probably don't know about Pledge for Veg. We've got from the old people who've gone to football matches, people in churches, people in the town centre, people in school, all the primary schools. Hopefully there's somebody who knows something about Pledge for Veg and what it means.
We've been to All Saints Primary School in Clayton.
We have put a lot of effort into this. When we've been everywhere and we've tried to get all our community to come together and grow something really easy.
Then we went to St Mary's, as our twistle.
The general public, what else?
We've asked our MP.
Yeah.
Well, we're at Connor, do you know?
Yeah, I think we plan to do
very successfully. You should plant them straight in the ground when the ground is warm enough.
St Christopher's School is in a very poor area of Hyndburn, in one of the poorer wards. And what my job is to do is to encourage people from those wards in particular to get involved in the food growing experience. We linked up and we started supporting each other's projects.
We're going down to Tesco to try and convince people to pledge for veg, and we'll be giving them pots of onions and garlics for free. It's good for the environment and it always tastes better. There's no nasty chemicals and things in the food and gives yourself a sense of pride in a way.
Hopefully encourages people because they go away not only with a pledge that they've signed, but they go away with a free pot with something growing in it.
For every pot we give away, we've calculated it's 1.5 kilograms of coal we're saving. Food miles, the growing, the fertilisers, transportation costs, all those kind of things. And not only that, we've saved them money. And obviously in this times of austerity, we feel if we're saving people money and giving them something healthy, we're doing the right thing.
I think they're absolutely wonderful, taking their own time out, you know, and understanding what eco means. And if they're doing that now, then you would hope that they will, through the rest of their lives, uphold the eco theme and what it's all about.
It's really good. We started off up here and we managed to get all those people, and that's just me. There's like 3 of us already down there, and then there's a lot of us up here.
And I've got 33 pledges so far.
Thank you very much.
We've managed to get everybody involved, and like we're all planting at home.
We grew tomatoes, onions, carrots, and then my granddad grew some tomatoes.
It only started off with us 10 doing it, and now we managed to get up to about 2,000 people doing it.
We've sent letters out to lots of different people, trying to convince them to pledge for Edge, and most of them have replied saying yeah. Sometimes they say no because they don't have a garden, but then we just say, well, you don't really need a garden, you can just put it on your windowsill.
They're passionate about what they're doing. They know it's right, they know we should grow our own veg, they know our over-reliance on unseasonal food is wrong, and because they believe it, people are listening to them and they're convinced by what they're saying.
We're here to get the Accrington Stanley football players their signatures for our Pledge for Veg campaign.
So we're going for organic grow, aren't we?
And it's not flown
up. Do you grow your own veg at home?
I don't, to be fair. I don't know. We tend to go to supermarkets.
Not vegetables, but I've got a herb garden back at home. I'm a keen gardener.
Do you realise the importance of growing and not always just going down to the supermarket?
It's better. It's cheaper as well, isn't it, to grow your own? You know, and you can pass on to other people, can't you?
Would you like to pledge for veg?
Yeah, absolutely. Of course I can.
Would you like to put your name on?
Yes, no problem at all.
There you are.
Thank you.
And seeing you girls today may just, you know, enlighten one or two things and give us some food for thought, basically.
And by signing that, you get a free starter kit with 200 bulbs and a garlic bulb.
Fantastic, just what I need for my new house.
The players took it on board really well, and obviously the girls and some of the lads got lots of pledges before off other people around, so yeah, it's definitely a really good year.
We didn't actually realise that the stuff that we're eating now was flown in for all these different countries. And
some people get like potatoes shipped in from like Egypt and oranges from Spain.
You can grow them perfectly well in England. And there's no need to like get rid of all those fumes into the air.
When we could like be growing stuff in our own backyard and reducing food miles and saving our energy that we've got because it's non-renewable.
We're at Blackburn Rovers football training ground and we're trying to encourage them or to start growing their own veg. Excited. Because we get to meet them and it's like, it's really nice that they're coming to like help support us.
So you
can grow all this inside as well. Like this.
They could do, yeah, you could
yeah.
Grow it inside.
I'm in a flat in England, so I don't have any. How do you do on my balcony if I'm going to do this? So.
I could probably grow a few in my goal if you want me to. Plant some big onions on the line so the ball can't go in.
That's a well good idea.
Down in the corners.
These pots, I can encourage you to start growing your barn.
Are you going to give us these pots?
Yeah.
Yeah? Definitely. I'll come back in 3 weeks and show you what I've grown.
Yeah.
Yeah?
We were at Accrington's down there asking people to pledge for veg.
They were really mature, asking the members of the public different questions, and some questions I hadn't even thought of, so that was good.
Everyone needs to join in together, really, to make a difference. My mum helped me grow like carrots in boxes in the garden, and I've started with the pledge boxes, which is onions and garlics.
We walk instead of using the car, and sometimes catch the bus. I grow my own veg, which is healthy for you, and I recycle because I have different bins for different stuff.
We're probably going to continue with the pledge because that's quite fun and it's good getting out and helping everyone and raising awareness.
Oh, it's gone really well. It's been a real learning curve. I've learnt loads of different skills, teamwork.
If somebody's down, somebody will cheer up. If somebody's quite good, somebody will calm them down. If we're going to do something like rehearse an assembly, we'll do it.
The confidence has grown from being very shy and literally hiding behind me to do it to coming forward and actually taking the lead.
Favourite bit was going to Tesco because I don't know why, I just liked going up to people and asking them to pledge a veg because I used to be really shy but now I'm not.
We're going to be doing like eco fairs every year, I think, now, just like bringing the community together. Every summer.
We've been out to different places, we've been just doing a lot of after school events in our own time, and it's not just like we're working through our dinner time or something, we're coming in after school and before school and things, and we're really working hard.
So we're making a real difference. We didn't get made to do this, we actually chose to do this, and we're enjoying it, and we think that we should carry on. Because it's fun to get all messy and you can have a laugh with your mates.
I had fun doing it in the process and it was really good.
They've really risen to the challenge in an imaginative and innovative way.
Well, already with Accrington Stanley, they want us to come back and see how we've been going, been the programme. They're going to put a little feature in each week to see how we're going.
So, yeah, it's good. It's good that they're promoting this. So, encouraging.
They were very, very enthusiastic. They're the ones who asked to do it. They led the way, really.